Hi all, good morning. In this session, we are going to see about the two topics, test planning and test plan components. First topic is test planning. First of all, I will tell you what is called as a plan. A plan is a document that provides a framework or an approach in order to get the software product for achieving a set of goals. The plan can have two forms. One is business-oriented, next one is technical-oriented. Business-oriented means it will be in the form of long-term plans, that is, economic growth of an organization. And then in terms of technical-oriented means, it is in the form of specific software product to be developed. Also, we can have some of the models, that is, B model or the extended or modified B model, that will help to plan the activities based on the starting stage of the requirement phase. Based on the set of goals, the plan describes some of the specific tasks to be accomplished, in who is going to take the complete ownership for the task, in what are the tools we can use and procedures and the techniques to be used, and how much time and effort is being needed, and what are the resources are available in order to perform this thing. Plan also contains some of the milestones. What is called as a milestone? Whenever we are in the middle of the project, we can have the milestone as a project to be attained to a certain level, that is deliverable level. Milestone can be defined as an event that are expected to occur at a certain time in the project's lifetime. So managers use the milestone in order to determine the project status. Next one is, this test planning is a difficult task and also it includes detailed documents. So we can have the high level items. What are the high level items? Are they overall test objectives, what to test, so who will test, how to do test, then when to test and when to stop testing. So what is the purpose of testing? What we can get in this form of testing? That will be mentioned in the test objectives. Then what to test, so it is what is the function or what is the item or what are the features to be tested within the scope of the test. Then who is going to test, who is going to do the complete ownership of the testing, that will be whole test. Then how to do this, that is what are the strategies to be used, what are the methods I use, then what are the tools, under software tools to be used in order to perform testing. Then when to test describes the schedule of the testing. Then when to stop testing describes the some of the conditions to be given in the test plan. Based on the conditions, they will decide whether the tester or the manager will decide when to stop the testing. Next is hierarchy of test plans. What is called as a hierarchy of test plans? It will include the quality assurance and also the test plan. So first of all, we tell the first level is the software quality assurance (VMV) plan. It consists of all the verification and the validation activities to be carried out, as well as the activities related to the audits to be carried out. And the below level is the master test plan and the review plan. Master test plan consists of overall description of external based testing, and the review plan it consists of workthroughs and the inspections. Then another level of hierarchy will be based on levels of testing, that is what are the levels of testing you can have, unit testing, integration testing, system testing and acceptance testing. So these are the levels of testing you can have. So corresponding plans will be there for all the levels. It will be under the master test plan. This master test plan is being developed by the project manager in the case of personal testing group. If the testing group is available, then tester or the SQA team, they will be performing this master test plan. But they need to get the help from the project manager. So that's all about the test planning. Next, we are going to see about the test plan components. There are 16 components in the test plan components. We'll see one by one. First one is test plan identifier. This tells about the what is the unique identifier for the associated project and also related to the project history, and how we can describe this identifier using the organizational standard. They will describe this identifier using some of the format and how to specify the version number. Next component is the introduction. In this component, the test planner gives the overall description of the project, and what is the software product being developed or being maintained, and what is the software item to be tested, and also the features it will be mentioned over here. Next one is items to be tested. So what are the entities are there? What is the name of the project? What is the version number of the project? Everything will come under the entity that also need to be tested. And what are the items are there? Procedures. What is the procedure we are going to carry out? Then what is the task we are going to use? Then methods, then objects, then libraries and subsystems. These are the items to be tested. Next component, features to be tested. What is called as a feature? It is a distinguishing characteristic of the software. It is very well equivalent to the non-functional requirement. It is what is called as a non-functional requirement. The performance, availability, portability, usability, these quality requirements will come under the non-functional requirement, and also it will stay the functional requirement as well. Next one is approach. What is called as an approach? It covers all the issues to be addressed whenever you are testing the software, and also the testing activities are described. So this will also include some of the features or the combination of the features, what kind of approaches we need to follow. The next component is the item pass or fail criteria. The tester must have a set of criteria to decide whether the corresponding test cases are passed or failed during the execution, and also failure, how it occurs when the actual output is being failed to meet the corresponding requirement in the expected output. That is called the failure. Next one is suspension and resumption criteria. So we need to mention the criteria to suspend the testing and criteria to resume the testing should be described in the test plan component. That is, for example, whenever we need to suspend the work in the end of the day, then we need to resume the testing in the next day morning. So these type of the condition should be mentioned in the test plan document. So what condition we need to suspend the testing, and what condition the testing should be resumed, under which it has been suspended earlier. These are the conditions to be specified in the test plan document. Next one is test deliverables. What is called as a deliverable? It is a test plan along with this test design specifications, test cases and test procedures. What is called as a test design specification? It specifies the requirements of the test cases. What is called as a test case? It is the expected output based on the input and the function. And what is a test procedure? We are going to follow these steps of the testing. So that is the called as the test procedure. Then deliverables also include other documents that is to capture the results of the testing in the case of test logs, test transmittal reports, and test incident reports, and test summary reports. Next one is testing task. What is called as a testing task? One of the structure it is there to describe the testing task. The text structure is called as the work breakdown structure. That is a hierarchical or tree-like representation of all the tasks that are required to complete a project. Okay, so it will be higher level task, it will be there in the top level. In lower level task, it will be there in the mid level. That is also called as the work package. It should be done by one or three persons in a short period of time. That is 3 to 5 days. Next one is testing environment. It describes the hardware and the software needs for the testing to be carried out. What is the hardware needs? Hardware needs describes any equipment to be tested. That is, any kind of laboratories will be required to do the testing. That all will come under the hardware. What about the software? Database or the test data generator. These are all will come under the software. The next component is responsibility. So staff who is going to do these, all these testing, they should be responsible for certain types of things. That is, first of all, he or she wants to transmit the software under the test. Next one, develop the test cases, test design specification and test procedures. Then execute the testers and record and monitor the testing. Then checking the results and communicating with the developers for the case of defects. And then managing the equipment, and also we need to develop the test harness, which is a very important core for the unit testing and the integration testing. Next one is staffing and training needs. It describes the staff and the skill levels needed to perform my task-related responsibilities. Next one is scheduling. What is called as a scheduling? We can have the task durations and also the task milestones that should be established and also recorded. The next one is risk and contingencies. What is called as a risk? Every project has a risk associated with it. How we can identify the risk? First of all, we need to follow some of the steps. First step is identify the risk. Second step is evaluate the risk in terms of probability. The next one is prioritize the risk. And next to last one is contingency plan to be developed in case of this happens. Next one is testing cost. What is called as a testing cost? Testing cost, it is a factor which should be maintained in the project management plan. Then project manager along with the developer and the tester, they will do the cost estimation. Then test cost to be included in the planner. Cost of planning and designing the testers, and the cost of acquiring the hardware and the software, and the test regarding the test harness and supporting the environment in executing the testers, recording and analyzing the testers. So these are the costs to be included in the test plan component. Next one, key characteristics. So what are the key characteristics are there in the testing components? So first one is nature of the organization. It's testing maturity level and gender maturity. It describes the test planning, then types of testing to be carried out, and types of testing tools needed to support. So these are the things that will be there. And second one is nature of the software product being developed. First of all, we need to understand what is the software system is being developed. So whether the system is a real-time system, embedded system, or the typical system or the business application system. Next one is the scope of the test requirements. It defines the non-functional requirement, that is performance, reliability, and usability. Next one is level of test ability, that is what is the education the tester has, then what kind of training we can give, then what kind of experience level the tester has. All these things will impact their ability to go into the project and to support the organization. And next one is knowledge of the project problem domain. That is, we cannot expect all the testers to have the corresponding knowledge. They can have the knowledge in case of knowledge is being less, then we can have the outside experts that also will impact the total cost. The level of tool support. So what are the tool support we can have? So what are the tools available for designing and executing the test cases and collecting and analyzing the test results? So these are the tools we need to support, so that cost also will be impacted in the total cost. Last one is training requirements. Next one, we can have some of the approaches to test cost estimation. First approach is models and heuristics. Second approach is impact items and test cost drivers. Third one is test task and test WDS, that is work data structure. And then fourth one is we can have Delphi method. And then fifth one is developer or tester ratio. So all these approaches are there to do the cost estimation based on the database historical data. So first of all, I'll tell you what is being called as a cost driver. Cost driver is a process or a factor, we can say. What is called as a product factor? It will also affect the overall cost. So project cost and the cost driver is all depends on the nature of the project in the organization. Then models we can use is COCOMO model. It is a very famous model for cost estimation. So project manager first decide the estimate the size of the project and also identify the types of the organization. We can have the equation to calculate the estimated effort. It is E equal to A into size of the project in kilo lines of code, that is 1000 lines of code to the power of B. A and B are the constants and E is the estimated effort. Next one is cost drivers also include some of the attributes. First attribute is product attributes. It will monitor the level of availability, and hardware attribute it will monitor the memory constraints, and personal attribute it will come under the experience level, and project attributes it will use of the tools and the methods. Next one is testing task. It can be represented using WDS. This is the example of WDS for testing related tasks. We can have 10 tasks under any high level task. It can be divided into low level tasks. For example, if we take one of the what the higher level part, that is tool selection, what are the tools are there, how we need to select it, what is the training we can provide it, how we need to execute it. So these are the steps to be followed in the lower level task. That is called as the WBS English for SLP. And last component is approvals. What is called as an approval? So all the test plan components has been defined and all that is still documented. One thing we need to approve it by somebody that should be designated by the organization. Whoever is called as the approver, they should sign in the test planning area that all the document or whatever the details are there in the document has been approved. So that's all about the test plan components. In the next video, we can see about the test plan attachments and the review reports and all the other topics. Thank you.